I'm Magic Skittles, and this is
1-800.
Fucker riding a pussy.
Not joking about that either.
But I wouldn't count on me having that for too long. I changed my gamer tag a lot. Alright, so welcome. Here we are today. We're going to be reviewing, playing, and doing a walkthrough of the game Destiny for the Xbox One.
So before the game even starts, there's three classes to choose from. There's Titan, Hunter, and Warlock. My personal favorite is the Titan. Okay, that was...
Fuck, man, I'm sorry. Yeah, I play the Titan too. It's really fun, but for just this game, I decided to go with the Hunter, and he's playing the Warlock. So we're gonna jump right into the character selection, how you can customize your characters. Obviously, you can see these graphics just make you hot and bothered.
Yeah, I like how you can choose from, like, no matter what side or opinion you had, if you did any research on Destiny beforehand, how you can choose a Human, Awaken, and Exo. And for some reason, Exo, well, I know what Exo is because I've played the storyline, but if you haven't done any research, Exo is pretty much looks like a robot.
It's like an exoskeleton of a robot without any of the armor, I guess. It's almost like a naked looking robot. I decided to go with it. I played the Awoken with my Titan, but this Exo just looks sweet shit, so here we are going through, kind of looking at all the different faces. End up choosing this one right here. The skin palettes are crazy. There's so many different colors that you can go with, so many different schemes. I know for the Exo itself, the whole bottom row, it's all different colors of camouflage. And then you have your solid colors in the top two rows.
Yeah!
You haven't gotten the part where I've gotten to. I'm not gonna spoil anything.
Yeah, I know. These head features are freaky,
like,
man.
What is that?
Yeah, what the hell is going on with this thing? So you got little devil horns.
Looks like he's getting like a... I don't even know, like brain surgery.
It's like a sleep study, you know? I decided to go with this cool little plate. I should have stuck with the black.
It looks like shades on his eyes.
Yeah.
What color did you go with?
Like Oakley's in the future. So this is a crucial part in the game. For those of you who don't know how to move your character, the left thumbstick, and it'll teach you. It's this one right here. You see this one? Yep.
Sometimes campers don't know what that is. Okay. Maybe knob it on it. I don't know.
It's too much Call of Duty.
That was not knobbing. I was totally doing my left thumbstick. But you gonna act like you're playing or what? Yeah, when I first played this part, I'm not gonna lie, I got scared because I didn't know what to expect while playing this game, and then those creatures were just ginormous, and I thought they were gonna attack me right away with like a boss.
I need to find you a weapon before the
but more, it's like you can run around and they don't attack.
So I don't play scary games at all. I tried playing Dead Space. That was a bad time. That this little guy that crawls through a little shaft right there scared the shit out of me.
He scared you too.
Yeah, dude.
This is the introduction, obviously. I'm
really nice.
Sometimes it doesn't make sense because the fist comes out first. I don't know. Maybe he punches him in the knife in the throat. I don't know. Oh, there you go with your headshots already.
One thing that I didn't know about this when I first played it through, this is my second time playing through, is that this first weapon is actually automatic. So I would never figure that out unless I just decided one time to hold it down. And, it's shot like an automatic, but usually when you do a trigger squeeze, you'll get like 2-3 rounds off. Not in this one, I mean, it's almost like a semi-automatic.
1 second, this right here is loot. The loot in the actual world will not be like this. This is, I'm guessing it's going to stand out just because it's the beginning. It's trying to show you that you can collect loot in boxes throughout the world. And I believe there's about 5 or 6 in each world.
As you can see, I got that Calcutta. It's a sniper rifle. It'll show you in the upper right, it'll show a little box with your icon or your weapon, and all you do is press the start button, and you can go through, and you'll find whichever weapon you just got. There's multiple weapons that you can stack inside of each type of weapon, like your primary, your special, and your heavy. So obviously the first one, you throw it out of the box, my special is my sniper.
So I really can see what I just saw. Did you just Call of Duty that?
Yeah.
I can't Call of Duty that, you think.
You see, a great thing about this game is most FPSs or first-person shooters that you get into, the intro, the teacher that's playing the game, is pretty dry. This whole entire thing you've been watching right now is all your introduction to the game. So this whole entire first part, up until when you get your first ship, it's all introduction. It teaches you the mechanics of it, kind of how it runs. It's really smooth. And I actually have had a lot of fun playing through this first part.
Incoming.
It's not hard to grasp. It's actually
this close to the surface.
But I had a lot of fun with it. It's got a really big Halo feel for it because the crews are from the party. That's one thing that really drew me to this game, is it was almost like a modernized Halo, because Halo was really futuristic, you know, like, you see it in the weapons more than anything, other than human weapons, more like alien weapons, are they're pretty crazy, but in this game, they're pretty normal, for the most part, but I actually really like playing with these weapons.
And this right here, in the game, you can hit the, for an Xbox One, it's this little, I don't know, we might pop a screen up or whatever, but like, it's like the two squares put together, like you're gonna...
It's like the back button on the original 360
controller. Yeah, the back button for Xbox 360 on the 60 PS3 would be the select button, and it pretty much brings up your ghost, and since there's no pause, it's also a big factor, which I don't think we brought up, there's no pause button in this, it's a big MMO online, and you need internet to play this game online, or play this game, period. Because you're always connected to the people in the world. They have random challenges for all the people on that world slash map or mission. And you pretty much team up to try to do a mission. And it's a short mission, but it's hard. And you get like bronze, silver, and gold. And obviously when you get gold, it's...
I'm picking up signs of an
old jump ship. You get a lot more experience and some bonuses.
Could be our ticket out of here.
Now that he just leveled up, sorry.
Okay.
He's gonna pretty much show you the skill tree. The skill tree is impressive to me. I've not seen an MMO with a skill tree. I'm gonna give you some of your grenade right there.
Yeah, I just got my first grenade. It's in that lower left corner. It's the, looks like a grenade, a little swerving grenade. And it's on cooldown, so it's not like you use it, you gotta pick up more. It's a cooldown ability.
There you go with the cutscene.
I really like that this game has a lot of cutscenes. And it really immerses you in the gameplay. A lot of games don't focus too much on that kind of a story. So this one really, it puts you in the game. But it's not a single player experience. Like obviously, I play alongside with Daniel right here. But you're playing with other people. I mean, it's not just you running around. That's why it's crucial for you to have internet to even play this game, is because it's a multiplayer experience. No matter where you are in the game, it's always multiplayer. So if mommy and daddy bought you this game, your Xbox One for Christmas, and you guys don't have internet for some guy, you might want to go knock on the little door and hey mom and dad, I'll watch the car and give you some internet.
Bringing you in. You can come back to them when you're ready. Let's get you home.
Every time you finish your mission, it's going to give you a rundown of what you did during that mission. So obviously it could be kills, precision kills, or headshots, and then any kind of rewards that you're given. Here we are at the tower. So like I said, it's a huge online multiplayer experience. You can see here's Go-Go Power Rangers. It'll have a little level up there, and a B for interactions. If I can do wee dingling. Yep, there he is right again. So here right here you can view the map if you're a little confused as to where to go. This guy, he sells engrams. And not only does he sell them, but you'll pick them up from killing people. And what it does is it unlocks a special kind of armor through a gunsmith, got all different kinds of weapons that scale up to future levels, so if you want to buy in advance, I wouldn't suggest it because you can honestly get better weapons just by going on a quest. If you use your bounty tracker, and what you do is you go through and you can buy these bounties from them. Now, each one gives you a little mission, dependent on what planet you go to, and they reward you with your reputation and spirit. You have your separate vendors for your different classes. There's three of them right around this table here. First one is the Warlock. And you've got your Hunter, and then your Hunter. So you've got your Hunter, and you'll see he gives you your first piece of armor right there, tight. And then you've got all your different kinds of armors that he can sell you. And usually they're a lot better for you. Versus other armors that you have. Now, your new mission is to pick a new armor, and you're just gonna go here, find whichever one was better, and you're gonna equip it. Now, when you're done with that armor, what are you gonna do with it? You can't sell it, so you dismantle it. You're gonna hold down your X button, and the little bar is gonna pop up, and the very bottom is gonna turn red, right there, and it's gonna give you currency, so it's like 16 little blue squares. And here's your ship light, so how we got that first ship. The very first part of the introduction. And we'll go up to this one right here. And to use the new character. When you get a little later into the game, you're going to have to spend money to buy new vehicles and ship blueprints. So now that you have your ship, open up your ghost. And you now have the option to go into orbit. Open up your ghost, and here you go, you can go straight into orbit just by holding another Y button. Now, going into orbit is a way for you to go from point A to point B. Say you have a mission in a different planet, you're gonna open up your menu, go to your orbit.
Orbit is pretty much self-explanatory. It's like the main menu for trying to see what mission you want to do, except they did a little differently this time. This is pretty much the main area where you party up with your friends. You either press Y, triangle, whatever system you're on, and you'll bring up your friends list. Speaking of, actually, that was pretty weird. Yeah. you just click on their name. You actually inspect their gear, invite the fire team, inspect player, get a gamer card from this right here. That's the tower site right in the center. Earth, moon. The moon will be on the left. Venus will be on top of that. There's this little...
We don't remember the name of it.
We don't remember the name of it.
It's Uranus. How about
and
that?
Then the Mars is right where he was circling. And that's the Crucible Online.
The Crucible is your online part, your matchmaking part. So there's no way for you to go into your main menu and enroll into a match or get into matchmaking. You actually are in-game and you separate yourself from matchmaking. So I think that's really cool. You do it at any time, so you don't have to keep going in between your campaign and your matchmaking. It's all put together in one. So it's a lot more confusing. So say you have a group of friends and you guys are looking for a little more of a challenge. Go down here and it says, hey look, it's a normal level 2. You get a bonus experience for 1800 points. If you want a little harder, here you go, level 3. Now depending on how high you are in these different quests, the level gap is going to be grow. So you definitely want to make sure that you're ready for these fights. But it's worth it because you get more experience and your turnaround is much bigger.
The other really interesting part is the fact that I've never seen any game really do this before. It had said no respawn area, I believe. Or no respawn area. Respawn is restricted. I'm illiterate, really bad. And pretty much all it is, it's not that you can't respawn, it's just that if you die in like single player, not a party, you have to start the entire thing over again. Not the entire mission, but the entire section to where it said spawning restricted. But if you're playing with a party, you're limited to pretty much one person dying, because they can be revived within a 27 second period.
I think it's like 30 seconds.
And if you can't pick them up, pretty much they just spawn back where it originally said spawning restricted, and then you pretty much continue on with your day. But if you both die, you have to start back over again.
And usually when you hit these spawning restricted areas, it means you're going to have a boss fight. So you definitely need to get in the zone and remember you the strategy, using your abilities and your grenades, all that kind of stuff. Everything is given at key strategical points in the game. Because it may not seem like a huge deal in the beginning, but as you get onto different planets, different missions, and different areas, it gets a lot harder.
Another thing too, I do die in this one because I decided to go run up and punch the guy. But apparently, I got my own character, and I was thinking I was a badass, but it didn't work. There you go. See, yeah, I went to go punch him, and he just stepped on me like I was a bug or something. And he just,
a little piece of cereal on the ground.
It was very bad. It didn't even give me a warning. He just automatically killed me. So this is where he goes. You get a certain time limit. There's no way to lower the time if he revives you. You get a little shield boost right here. So in case you're getting shot at, because it takes about maybe like 1 to 2 seconds to revive somebody. And then it gives you a shield.
You just killed an archon, and we got a warp drone. This was crippled. You need to go see this video.
And there we go, that's our first episode. If you like this video, go ahead and like it. Please subscribe, that'd be great. We're starting off fresh. We have previous channels, we have pretty known Twitches, but we definitely have something that's kind of new, a dual commentary and a walkthrough. It's going to be great. So we just want your feedback. We want to know what you want to see, what you expect, what you didn't like, what you do like, and leave it all in the comments below. We'll see you guys later. Now I'm gonna jack off.